Yeah, I got that's a good question. You know, I watched the last fight this week, but going by fast as hell, so I'll be in there fighting soon. So I think, just, you know what I'm saying, with my mindset and how I feel about boxing and how I'm thinking, like, I think that, like, you know, I made some simple mistakes, you know, but they wasn't elementary mistakes, you know. Like, you gotta y'all gotta really go back and watch a lot of that fight. And then as you judge the fight, you look at, like, a lot of punches getting landed and hit on the hand, and then those kind of recoil towards my face or my body. So it kind of looked like I'm getting hit, especially if you're sitting below me. So I have to look at it from the judge's standpoint of view. And that's what's important about this fight, is trying to also judge the fight, win this fight, not just off of the judges, but win the fight off of, like, you know, from the best standpoint, from the judges, but knock him out, so you ain't got to worry about that.
How,
you know,
it's crazy. Power in the last bout. A lot of people made a lot of comments online on our channel and a lot of other channels that they thought you got rocked. Can you talk to us about his power during the bout?
Well, I got hit with a flush shot in the third round, especially me reviewing the fight, and that's a part of boxing. You know, like, that's his sport. I know it's hitting don't get hit, but, you know, I took a very, very clean shot straight to the face, you know, so I didn't get dropped. You know, I bounced back on the ropes. I had a few seconds left. I was bobbing and weaving my head right after all of that, so I couldn't have been too fucked up if I was using my head movement. So, but his power is just a normal puncher's chance, you know what I'm saying? It's the difference between being devastating and dangerous and, you know, just a decent fighter with power, and I think that his opposition hasn't been nowhere close to mine, so... You know, with 30-something fights, I got only 18 knockouts. But if you look at my box rec, y'all will see a lot of my opponents had desperation fights that they had to come back and win. Number two, two fights on their, you know, losses, or fought undefeated fighters. So it's like, you know, that's why I said I want to hear about that other motherfucker, TC. They got Earl the Big Short knocking at his door. He ain't fought no opposition like me. You know what I'm saying? But, I mean, I don't care to be on nobody pound for pound list. Y'all don't like me? Fuck y'all. Y'all gonna watch me fight this weekend. Y'all gonna see me fight, and y'all gonna have to respect me eventually. So now, I'm gonna earn mine.
You have a lot of.
Would it surprise you from the first bell Costano just came out trying to dog you, like, from first bell? Would that surprise you?
That's why I work very crafty on my feet work. You know what I'm saying? It's it don't matter what he does. You know what I'm saying? It's about what I'm doing in there. So protect myself at all times. Come in that motherfucker and just, you know, throw my shit. He can't do nothing with good feet and a lot of power in his face too. So he got two arms, two legs, and I'm gonna do what I gotta do. I got the same thing.
And you fought everybody 154.
I wanted to ask you about his power in particular, because a lot of folks thought that you were hurt, but how much of that was truly just defense? It looks like when you got clipped, you changed levels immediately, and you were very cognizant.
Clip is going down, so that's the wrong terminology, but I didn't go down. I got hit with a good shot in the third round. I explained that before. Right after that, I was back on my defense. So I explained to you already about his power. I just told you it's not the most devastating power. I just said that, my exact words. So you gotta pay attention. You know what I'm saying? Don't be the guys that just listening to what these people in the comments say. Be the guy that's speaking up for him. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, I just said his power ain't shit. What y'all want me to say? Y'all want me to talk shit. Y'all want me to be the bad guy. Y'all want the worst. God damn, why? I gotta be humble before my fight. I got my mind right. My spiritual levels are high. And my energy is up. But, I mean, shit, you ask some dumb questions and you keep asking the same dumb questions, I'm gonna start getting upset. And then that's when this is stupid to him. This is the one that talk. Nah, I'm not none of that. Like, I'm just intelligent. I'm conscious of all my shit that I got going on. I'm aware. I'm not like just letting you motherfuckers just tell me anything. I'm paying attention to what y'all saying, because I don't listen to you motherfuckers anyways. So, you know, there you have it. You know, I'm fighting live on Showtime, and I appreciate them for keep on putting me on, and I'm steady making money. I feel like it's a badass NFL contract. Ha, 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 this money up. You know what I'm saying? Keep on going like that. I'm going to have more money than some of their stars.
Now, speaking of stars, you have tons and tons of celebrity friends. How many of them hit you up for tickets?
Nah, none of them. They support me. They don't buy. They go buy the tickets. I don't even deal with that. They holler at me later. You know what I'm saying?
Who's
they watch the fight
house?
On.
Who's going to be in the house?
I don't know.
Okay. I am.
My twin brother in there.
But that shows real support. When they buy, it shows real support.
Right. It's all right. It's support. Support is support. If they watch it or can't get there, they got to watch it from the TV. It's cool. It's all going to go some type of way, add up.
Jamel, with the victory on Saturday, obviously you'd be undisputed. Does that put you feel in the maybe the best of all time at 54?
I think me winning the 4-bet era, undisputed title, yeah, I think they can't say no bigger no bigger star in boxing than me and 154. They're going to have somebody come up. Every title is meant to be taken, you know what I'm saying? So I'm okay with that, you know what I'm saying? I'm fighting, I'm enjoying this shit, I'm having fun with this shit. I'm fucking motherfuckers up. Like, this shit is tight, you know what I'm saying? So I'm interested. This is wealth right here.
Yeah, so Saturday, like you're going to get that credit you deserve.
Right now, where is this coming from? You seem like you're so happy. It's supposed to be a script, like you're in such a good place. Can you talk about it?
I mean, I'm good on weight. You know what I'm saying? A few pounds over. Been a few pounds over since like last week. So weight, I'm not stressing about nothing. And that's what I did. I took a lot of time out, cut a lot of idiots out my life and out my way, and just like stay focused, dead strong in the gym like I was back in the days, like the roots. You know what I'm saying? Get back to the hardcore boxing, training. Not nobody in the LA came to the gym. How many people was there?
Just you. You
my brother. My brother pulled up on me here and there sometimes. Man, I'll just be working, dog. And I get to finally, the day has come. You know, and Saturday I get to just show, you know, what I've worked on, and I show my skills, and I tempt myself and I pressure myself to like being better than what I was the last time y'all see me.
So you being in the ring with him already?
What?
Big advantage for you being in the ring with him?
I think so. Me being in the ring before, it creates a like, motherfucker, like I got your number already.
Yeah. Two more questions, guys.
Usually immediate workouts, we just see half a round of jump rope. You really went out today. Why?
I didn't really go out. I did three rounds in some shadow boxing, some three rounds, and I came and hit the bag. You know, just wanted to stay loose. I just got in on a nice PJ, thanks to Al Hammond. He flies private. I got here and then I came straight to you guys, you know. So then I go back, chill out for a little bit, eat something, and go work out tonight and relax, you know, just keep it the same mojo.
What do you want to leave with your fans this evening, man?
Hey, I want to be legendary. You know what I'm saying? I'm already feeling like a legend. I just want to be legendary. I want to take I want to just put a mark on my career right here. I think I take myself to another level after this fight.
Last question, guys.
Do you think you left any body work out there in the last bout?
Yeah.
Do you think you left punches out there?
Maybe so. Maybe y'all will see a little bit more of that. Definitely more effective jab. Effective jab. Listen. Effective.
Thank you, guys.
And everybody got tested, right?
Everybody got tested, even me, a whole bunch of times. Them motherfuckers came like 6 or 7 times. I hope he got tested like that. Straight up. They were drawing the hell out of my blood.
Yeah,
that's Bruce Lee. Coming out of
Leon's
son.
He didn't like the comments that you questioned on me to being a big fighter.
Yeah, thank you, man. Appreciate it. I think him being at home. I said I was emotional with him, I feel it. I hurt his feelings. Because he didn't show his self for truth. What's up, dog?
How you feeling, man?
I feel better when I see you. I'm happy. Like, I got happy.
Too, man.
He's ready.
Tesla? Yeah. I got some without gas. Gas $8 now, man. Out here,
that's why I asked him. Man, you was ahead of the game.
Prius and the Tesla.
You was ahead of the game. You want to know something else that's cool? Or, you know, like, Metal World Peace gonna be there, right? Mm-hmm. I said, ain't that a clever motherfucker? It motherfucker was Metal World Peace before all the Metal World. Yeah. They owe him. They owe him.
He also had a Tesla. One of the first to ever have one.
What?
A Metal World Peace.
He was the first. How you be knowing this type of stuff?
Because I was in his house. I was in the car.
Shit, right? After shit he make up.
You know, yeah,
he gave me a ride in his Tesla.
Man, he ain't give you no ride. He cut you off, man.
You know, he's a boxing manager, too.
This is my father, guys. You know what I'm saying? Look at Popsy. Look at y'all. Y'all wonder why them roots, where it come from. Yeah, like, he's like, hold on, champ. Yeah, this Pops, this is my dad.
Are you excited?
We're ready.
We dreamed about this when we were younger. He, thank God for Pops. He put us in the gym. He forced us to go. He whooped our ass when we didn't win. Yeah, it was a lot. It was bad, but you know, I'm glad. I'm happy to see him pull up on me, all the way out here in LA, straight from Texas. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. We worked our ass off.
Well, why'd you send
them
to the gym?
My brother.
I'm Modis as well.
Yeah, no doubt. What does it feel like having two championship sons that are twins nonetheless?
Listen, it's a joy. It feels good to witness all the things that I've actually spoken to my son since he's been a baby. These things been spoken of. And it's like what we'd always need. You know, I don't even want to use the word dream come true, because at the end of the day, it was shown to us. This is where we would be. So at this time, he at the right time in the right place of his life.
That's cool. Tear up my lip with you. You know, the people be having all them warriors. Yeah, when you're in that room.
Joyful. Yeah. They have accomplished all the things they've accomplished in their life, as far as boxing. and they have a lot more than they look forward to doing.
Were you a fighter in your life? What led you to put your boys in the gym?
Well, I fought them one time.
One of the most unlike motherfuckers in this game.
I think they like me too much. I've always kind of like feeling made sure that they was going to do
I love my
what
vodka.
I could do. They was going to accomplish
my Mexicanos.
Things. Was unable to do.
Your dad's in shape.
You've done that.
When was the time when you looked up and said, oh my
God, we got you. You asked me about Crawford. I'm going to have to put pops on you, Don.
My boys from both fighting. This is crazy.
Well, they was doing this coming out of the womb, so as far as knowing them, they both can fight. I would say it's early on, as 5, 6, 7 years old, when I used to put them out. When I was actually trying to fight at the time, training and working and putting in my work, and we would get out in front of the projects, and you know, we had a bunch of little kids around the project, so I said, hey, y'all ready to start practicing on your art? And that's what we did. I put them in front of other kids so they could get different looks. And these things that we did in the back rooms and in our closet, that I called the closet at the time, and sitting in the living room and working on technique. I was more of a technique type fighter, so I focused on, hey, sticking with the jab, sticking with straight right, making sure your foot is in the right place when you're stepping. And that's what we did when they were 5 or 6 years old, go outside and practice with other little kids. We don't call it practice. You know, we constantly worked on our art, and that's what he did, and he stuck to it. And it's the end results of it.
So you was the first lion.
Technician.
Said again?
So you was the first lion.
I am the lion. I'm the alpha. All
right, Paul, don't tell him no more. He's goddamn right. He's the first lion.
You like your brother's chances? The Canelo fight's still a big fight for him. You like his chances a little bit more?
If he can get it, I will accept it as it comes. You know, we don't know. It's not something that like we just like got our fingers crossed for. You got to keep moving in boxing. You know what I'm saying? And that's the thing about it. So like, a lot of people gonna say this and say that, but as long as my brother keeps stepping above all of that and keep fighting, I don't care who he fight, just fight. You know what I'm saying?
Based off the B-ball performance, do you like what you see there? Something your brother can expose at 116 maybe? Or?
And my brother, honestly, I hate to say it, he commit a little bit of more training with like DJ. And, you know, get to the, you know, Guzman and just get a little bit more clutch, I think he got a super good chance.
Yeah.
Ronnie Chase is great. I think, but it just, you hear from the same person for so long, it kind of like, you need a little bit of more extra to develop your skills. And I think that's all I think, my brother, that's all he's missing.
Can you clarify your Louisiana roots? A lot of people, they got a lot of
money.
Can you talk about that?
Raised, that's home for us. All my family grew up. Everything, Louisiana is where it's at for us. You know what I'm saying? My pops and his mom and dad and my grandpa and all my auntie, everybody is from Louisiana. And so everybody was, you know, back and forth from Texas to Louisiana. So that's where our roots at. Lafayette, Louisiana, Opelousas, Grand Coteau, Church Point, the Henrys, the Plum Boys, the Charlos, that's us.
You could have been alligators only.
Look at this guy.
Did you catch the Canelo fight?
Yes, I did.
What do you think of your other son's chances against Canelo now with the B-ball performance?
I'm like, well, through this song, reiterate what I just heard Bill saying. One of the things I always tell him when we were younger, and as he was younger, and moving out through boxing, was that we're not ever going to chase behind anybody. We're going to fight anybody that steps in the ring, no matter who they are, no matter what they have accomplished. We're gonna fight anybody. We're gonna fight.
Marv's at 160, and it's not looking good over there.
But we're just gonna keep moving
forward. He gotta, you know, fuck with 160 and 168, and then you'll catch a fish. You sometimes on that boat, you gotta sit there.
Yeah.
You'll get a big shark one day.
And they don't have to always use bait to catch.
When did you realize your boys were special? Like when you seen them, when you first seen them fight, when did you realize, okay, they different?
Well, I tell you. What I really knew they were different from a lot of the kids was that their dedication and their heart to learning the craft when they were younger. I'm saying we because we was all together part of it. So when we were younger, and I feel like I grew up with them in boxing at the same time, teaching them things that I was taught, the things that I've learned from other great fighters. I had the opportunity to come up in a gym era where nothing but greatness, world champions. I've been exposed to nothing but greatness, so I exposed that to them. And I added that and said that because what you asked. And what you just asked is how they were developed. into where they are today. So when I first noticed it, first saw it, is when, well, I had identical twin sons crawling and walking around the house at the same time. And from there, they were always in challenging one another. So when I saw them always wrestling and fighting amongst each other, forwards and play fighting and putting on boxing gloves on their own and sitting there and mimicking each other in front of each other like this in the ring. Well, I call it in the ring, we're in the living room, was the ring. And they would go back and forth all day. This was an all day thing. This is something they woke up to and went to sleep to. So as they got older, it was just what it was.
Don't give him too much. Don't tell him too much.
And you know what's crazy? You're still learning. You're still evolving. Even though everything you've achieved.
Now than I did when it was little.
Huh? I'm saying your education doesn't stop in boxing. You're still.
I like these motherfuckers sometimes.
By the way, who's here with you today? Who's everybody?
My dog Titus, what's up Titus, an ex-NFL pro, you know what I'm saying, I gotta put that out there for y'all, boy from Omaha too, so yeah, got an Omaha boy in the house. And then I got his wife with me, which is like my cousin. She is my cousin.
And then your dad, of course, came by today.
And then my pops came in. It's tight. And I got my dog, Big Carl, in the back. The body slam anybody that come next to me. Y'all see it? That's right, baby. No more Pop, don't, come on, Pop. Don't let me touch you.
How's it going? Great to see you. How you been though? Good? You're working hard. How's it going?
Yeah, it's
been
great.
He looks great. He looks amazing.
He's going to look good with all those belts.
I think it's going to be a short night.
Short. 7.
Sorry. Pedro? How you feeling? Hello, hello.
The show is over.
Show is over. That's it.
Boom, boom. 3 for 3 in camps, man.
That's it.
And from Earl camp to Jamel camp.
Earl looked great too.
And Jamal camp.
Let's do it.
All right. I feel like I got
everything. I reposted. Does the sprinter hold everybody? Thank you so much. Thank you. Yeah. Good stuff. You look great. You look amazing.
Yeah, ready to go.
You know what's crazy?
Wait, I think we might got
Mel, usually when people cut weight, they can't smile. You've been smiling all day. You're good.
Not they can, they won't smile.
They won't smile. They
want to. I'm happy, I'm thankful, I'm blessed. Life is amazing. 1 billion. ESPN News.
That's
reporting.
Reporting. Hey, are you? Yeah, over 1 billion, 40 million.
Come on, Derek.
Hey, but I told Derek, trainer of the year this year, there's no competition.
Reporting.
All right, we'll see you guys tomorrow. Thank you. Let me get a shot of them leaving. So there you have it. Stay tuned. PSWBorn.com. I'm Melissa back reporting that Charlo in his sprinter with the team. They're heading back to the hotel. Tomorrow's press conference. Stay tuned.
Kelly sent back. Reporting, guys. Okay, I'll be back live in a little bit, another gym.
Ellie Sekback reporting. But ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Eli Sekback reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Eli Sekback reporting.